Riley. Nope, no John. Nope, no Mitch.
Nope.
They outshoot their opponent 30-15 and win with a Bobby McMahon hat trick?
Yep.
That is surprisingly predictable.
This is actually the most predictable Leafs win of the season yet.
Let's go!
Good. We all feel
stop!
Good.
Never gets rusty!
What am I doing?
Into my kitchen! Producer Drew, can you fix all this?
And when it comes to the Toronto Maple Leafs, you can crumple, crumple, yeet!
Saw that going differently.
With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
Go,
victory, puppies! Iggy, do you know who Bobby McMahon is? Do you know? Come here! Have you heard about Bobby McMahon? Apparently, leafiness works in reverse, too! Leafs! Win 4-1 over the St. Louis Blues. And if Bobby McMahon was the only guy who scored tonight, they still would have won by two.
Now, I know what you're thinking. Some of you just got here. Steve! Don't yell at me. What do you think about the Morgan Riley suspension? I've already talked about that at length. I just did a video on this channel. It was uploaded during the game. So if you missed it, that's understandable. It was uploaded during the game. But if you want to check it out now, it's right here on this YouTube channel.
Steve, that's just a tricky way to get us to watch two videos.
No, it's a way to get you to not watch one half-hour video in the middle of February or a regular season game against the Blues. Now listen, these videos are about the Toronto Maple Leafs. It's Leafs fan reaction after all. I don't bust this out very often. I don't. Blues fans, if I were you,
dude.
I don't want to take the negative approach to this game. I want to take the positive approach and talk about the Leafs' victories. Not just the 2 points in the standings, but how on earth they were able to pull this off without Riley, without Mitch, without Tavares. And because Connor Timmins is out with mono and Tavares and Mitch are out with an illness, I'm not saying those guys have mono, but I am saying it's very likely that other Leafs were playing with, at very least, the sniffles. And it is admirable that they won. They pulled off the 2 points. It's admirable that they won at all, let alone, like, looked competitive. Like, they were the better team start to finish. And St. Louis Blues fans, if I were you, I'd be calling for the coach to be fired had they not already been fired earlier this season. Dude, earlier I said the Leafs outshot the Blues 30-15. I look now, it's 32-15. They didn't even hit 20 shots. You got more than doubled up by this? Max Domi was the second line center. They had 3 third pairs, and a dude who was supposed to be a healthy scratch ended up in the third line and got a hat trick. The Blues shots by period were 3, 8, and 4. They get outshot 13-4 in a third period that they were losing in the entire time. The Blues scored as many goals against themselves as they did against the Leafs. The Blues got as many goals off of shots as Bobby McMahon got off of bank passes off the boards. Look, I know the Sharks gave up 10 goals in back-to-back games. On this very night, the Buffalo Sabres absolutely slapped the LA Kings. Last I checked, it was 7-0 for the Sabres. But this? This performance against this Leafs roster, praise the Leafs for doing their job, but this has got to be like a bottom 20, 25 at very least performance from any team around the league this season. 15 shot, why'd you even get off the bus? Anyway, I think the Blues might be sellers. Okay, so let's talk. Heading into this game, there were some distractions. Mitch Marner and John Tavares are sick and they are not in the lineup. There's about $22 million sitting there in the press box. Or at home, I guess, under a blanket. Then there's Morgan Riley, who is far and away your best defenseman, and man, when you take him out of the lineup, it sure looks like it. The pairings were Brody Liljegren as the top pair, which some of you will remember from the podcast, I earnestly pitched should be the Leafs' third pair about a month ago, Benoit with McCabe and Giordano with Lagesson. But even though Riley's been there the whole time, the construction of the back end has been a problem all season, so I guess it wasn't that jarring. Losing Tavares and Mitch in one fell swoop was disturbing. Dude, this is what the lineup was heading into the game. Nyes, Matthews, Nylander. Okay, that's fine. We've seen that play together before. Bertuzzi, Domi, Robertson, McMahon, Kampf, Gregor, was earnestly at times the Leafs' fourth line, And the fourth line is Alex Steeves making his season debut, finally. Pontus Holmberg and Ryan Reeves. Oh, and Ilya Samsonov in net because Martin Jones is battling something. And I'm not going to lie, I'm not totally convinced that Samsonov isn't battling something too. I don't know if he just like gets up with a delay or what, like he's quirky. Stop it. Stop it. And in the same way that we can predict the Leafs are going to play the top teams in the NHL and give them absolute hell, and the Leafs are going to play a bottom feeder and probably get annihilated, I looked at this lineup, I looked at the forward group, I looked at the D-core, and I said the St. Louis Blues are taking a fat L tonight. Because that's how this team works. Producer Drew sent me an incredible stat during this game. So with this win against the St. Louis Blues, the Leafs are now 8-2-2 against the Central Division. That is exceptionally good. Two of those losses are against the Chicago Blackhawks! You want to know what leafy means? Leafy! Extremely leafy! But, all that. They can't win a game until they win the game. So, what do you got for me? What do you got next man up? And you're looking at the lineup and you're like, all right, well, the big guys who are remaining need to show up. Nylander and Matthews need to show up. It'd be pretty nice for a breakout from like a Max Domi or a Tyler Bertuzzi. And I actually have a great idea. To reward the Leafs for their valiant win in this game, on Wednesday, the Leafs shouldn't have a practice or nothing. They should just take all of Bertuzzi's sticks, take them into the parking lot of the practice facility, and light them on fire. Just bring a bunch of marshmallow. You can hand out all the duties to the rookies. You can say, you go get the marshmallows, you get the graham crackers, can someone handle the chocolate, and you light them on fire! But not before putting on a mask, like a surgical, like a painter's mask, and you wear a clove of garlic necklace around your neck, and also, what a cross. You need a silver cross. Tyler Bertuzzi did step it up in this one, and he tried his gosh darndest, and he should have had at least half a dozen points, but he didn't on account of cursed. I tell you what, if shooting regression is truly a thing that exists, Tyler Bertuzzi is about to win the Conn Smythe Trophy. So, okay, he can't hit the broadside of a barn. Who else can we rely upon? How about Bobby freaking McMahon? For the first goal, first of all, I just want to point out that you can see the shots, and at one point it was 2-2, which means after the first 5 minutes, the Blues only got 13 more shots. But dude, look at this. Noah Gregor had the puck, he got knocked down, and Bobby McMahon turned this nothing burger into a goal. Then McMahon protects the puck against the boards. It's Braden Schenn. It's Braden Schenn on him. And then he just beats him and goes around him. Schenn just sort of lets him go, to be honest. He drives the net. Colton Parayko just front row seats like, man, check that guy out driving the net. He's really hustling hard. And before he realizes, oh, wait a sec, that's my guy, McMahon beats Jordan Binnington to the far side. Bobby McMahon makes it 1-0 Leafs. And dude, I know he got a hat trick and I know we're gonna wax poetically about him for the whole video. That goal though, if that goal was the only one he scored in this game, that goal is why I've been telling you for weeks and maybe months, this dude needs more ice. This dude maybe deserves a promotion in the lineup, and he got one sort of on a technicality. The promotion was going from a healthy scratch to the third line. But I'm sorry, this guy can just do things that not everyone else on the team can do. He's one of the biggest forwards on this team in terms of height and weight. He's one of the faster guys on the team, low key, at least in bursts. He obviously battles along the boards, and his shot and hands are low-key nasty. Finer details, defensive game. Is that where a guy like Noah Gregor, for example, maybe wins the tiebreaker? Sure. But dude, that guy with those hands and that shot at that size, at that speed, that doesn't come along all the time. I'm not calling him a superstar, but the fact that the Leafs were even entertaining the idea of healthy scratching him before this game drives me nuts. If Mitch was there, if John was there, this player would still not be a healthy scratch on my team. Not a chance. Before the end of the first period, Phil the Thrill returns to rekindle his time with the Leafs. No, but it is actually weird that Phil Kessel appears in the news as apparently he's going to be skating with the Vancouver Canucks affiliate in the AHL. But then Matthew Kessel, who's on the St. Louis Blues from Phoenix, Arizona, scores for the Leafs. William Nylander takes a shot. It goes off of Matthew Kessel, and it's 2-0 Leafs after one because absolutely, positively, of course it is. Now, the Leafs outshoot the Blues 10-3 in the first period. They're up 2-0. You probably can't count on this game going this well the whole time. Timothy Liljegren battling with Alexei Toropchenko in front. I've talked about him in these LFRs. Well, guess what? He tips one in. Big body player, big body goal. Blues within one. Shots 8-9 in favor of the Leafs after that period, but it's obviously a lot more even. That is what it looked like the rest of the game was going to be like. It was going to be a dogfight. Third period comes around, the Blues got 4 shots, and not a single one of them was as nice as that nasty snipe from McMahon. And again, like, I want to give the Leafs their flowers here. The whole thing is just disgraceful from the Blues. It looked like a Leaf power play. It honestly did. And it was a makeshift third line that was actually the fourth line. Like, Bobby McMahon goes for a slap shot, misses the net by a mile. It rings around. The Leafs get it right back. They just go right back to work. Puck finds its way back to him. He snipes it. So now it's 3-1 and the net is empty. And I'm like, oh, Sheldon, I don't know. Because, dude, I mean, you gotta put him out for hat trick watch, but I'm like, is that what Bobby McMahon does? Is he shutdown guy with 2 minutes to go? I'm like, I don't know how much ice time he's gonna see. And then Sheldon send him out! Marc Giordano, low-key, really nice move to get it to McMahon. I didn't even know Giordano was healthy enough to play. Honestly, he might not be. Although I thought he looked pretty good. McMahon bounces it off the boards, and the whole time I'm like, you know what? That's a great play. Great bank play. Unselfish play to get the puck to, oh my God, it's gonna go in. Oh my God, go! Go! Yeah! Bobby McMahon! Hat trick! He scored 60% of the goals he has ever scored in the National Hockey League tonight. That is his 5th of the season. Puts him 1 goal behind Tyler Bertuzzi. We're not gonna talk about that. That's incredible! Like, dude. This is exactly what the Leafs need. And not even just because Mitch is out, Tavares is out, Riley's out. We always talk about the importance of the core of this team. But then we also talk about the lack of depth scoring. No matter how good the core is, if the core is really good, they tend to win. If the core is just good, it's kind of 50-50. If they're bad, you basically have no shot of winning. And we've been desperately looking for it. We need someone to hit double digits. Kelly Yarncroke did, got injured. All right, Matthew Nyes, he's almost there. Tyler Bertuzzi, I'll light candles for him. I don't know. Max Domi, I don't know. Nick Robertson is inching his way there, right? Still no. That was Noah Gregor's 50th game of the season, and he's got 5 goals. And I know it's one game. I know it's a one-off. There have been guys who have scored hat tricks in the NHL and they didn't really go on to do anything. But you saw it. You saw the tools that this guy has. You've seen the tools that this guy has. I need the Leafs to give the guy a bit of a run. He played like, what, 13 minutes in this one? I'm not even asking for that. Just give him a run. Give him some ice. Give him some offensive opportunities. I think he can do it, man. And I tell you what, Mitch and John get back. Let's say they play next game. You are not taking Bobby McMahon out of this lineup. How dare you? Alex Steeves is the call-up, so he's the free space. Ryan Reeves got bodied by a dude who's 40 pounds less than him. Have you ever held a 40-pound kettlebell in your hands? You know how much 40 pounds is? Here, wait a sec.
Hey, look at this! Look at this thing! This is... This is the difference between Nathan Walker and Ryan Reeves. Here, do you want... Listen. You hear that? I probably gotta fix the foundation there just to prove a point.
You listen to me. Bobby McMahon is not a healthy scratch on my hockey team. Mm-mm. Questions. Would it have been fun to see McMahon slap the puck into an open net for the Hattie? Yes. Yes, it would have. And then we, for several days, could act indignant, could act like it's the first hockey game we've ever seen, and be like, where did this Blues reaction come from? Although, based on the way the Blues played today, I think it would have been pretty peaceful out there. So, Toropchenko to the Leafs when? Mike, they don't need Toropchenko. They have Bobby McMahon. Was this game a promotion for the McRib? Because the McMahon is back, and it's for a limited time, so get it while you can.
Hey, hey! That's the difference between Bobby McMahon and the McRib. Bobby McMahon is here to stay!
And this is maybe the most important question. Do you remember watching Bobby's World when you were younger?
Yes, I do. I watched it all the time.
Dude, I just YouTubed it to make sure that impression was good. Look how young Howie Mandel is! How old am I? Oh, that's depressing. I'm wrapping it up here. That's we're done. So, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. And if you want to watch my reaction to the Morgan Riley suspension, it is the most recent video on this YouTube channel. So please check that out. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. If they scratch Bobby McMahon again, we riot!